What's up guys, Sekwon here, welcome back to more Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles. Last time, we did a lot of questing. Today, we're gonna head towards Magma Ruins. Is it? Yeah, I can't see if it's Magma or Tephra Cave. One of the two, it's something. It's called something. So, we have to go up here. I don't think hand bandits are abundant. Well, actually, hold on. We got another one of those rabbit thingy mobs. So, we can turn that in. We are now an ether up. Which is kind of pointless right now, but we are missing one thing, which is a vegetable item. Which I don't remember what it is. If I wanted to, I could go check, but I'm not going to. Because, why do I have to spoil stuff? Strong dandelion. But we do have to fight the wood bandits.
Let's do this. Leave it to Ryan.
So we'll do that real quick.
Okay.
And since we're so close to leveling up, this is gonna be no problem at all. Let's do that right now. We're gonna play as Ryan because we did get a new art. I never really showed it off, but I will show it off near. We still have to fight these guys, so we're gonna do that. Now we're gonna do a little bit of questing, but since this is on the path towards where to go, it's not that much of a questing anyway. It's like cleaning up a couple quests anyway. That quest is now done. We leveled up and. Do you want to get art? Yep, sure. So we can turn show that off. A little bit. I forgot to show off the art anyway. Good. Do all this stuff. There are still a couple more quests we have to do. Which, not with those guys. Is it up here? No, I think it's farther up. I don't think hand bandits are abundant on one, so we don't worry about that. Man, we're getting a lot of these rainbow zirconiums. I think there were rare items in. We got in like four. Oh, there was a quest I forgot to do. And it's actually down here. Ah, I knew I was forgetting that quest. I'll get it on the way back down. Actually, no, we're not gonna get on the way down. I'll show you guys what I've been doing. I wanna get up here and it is a quick travel point, and then we're gonna hop down there. And easily get what we need. What I want to fight is actually over here. It's right here. Evil Rangroot. So we're just gonna go right behind him.
Let's give him hell. Everyone,
so we're gonna go on up. So this, what you can do is get the aggro on us and then block enemy attacks. And we can't actually do anything. So you just block attacks. We can do it again to disable it, so it's kinda useful, not really. Laura's attacks, we don't have to worry about that. Put him with Toplum, and then we'll go wild swing! And for some reason I attacked him from way back there, which I don't know how that's even possible. Get the aggro on us, attack him, and boom up it. That missed, constantly. Why can I- okay. Luckily, the battle doesn't end, and he's actually chasing us. Never mind, the battle ended. At least against him, we start with this bunnet we can fight. At least he doesn't have that much health taken off him, but it's not. That was my fault. I should have. Okay, everyone, focus the evil bunnet thing in the bubble. The bubble. And oh, we do have to take care of hand bandits. Well, luckily, there's two over here anyway. That quest is now done. Bone, Papa, eat us. But yeah, I just love this game. It's not my favorite game, but it's up there. This game is just fun. Why did I just bring that up? Why not? We got an infinity coin because it's a unique monster. We got some new weapons. Let's grab some blue chain. And another blue chain. So many blue chains. So much blue chains. Anyway, keep on going up. Hold on, let me go check something real quick in the quest. Let's see, we still have the monster quest, which I'm thinking that's the colony crap rolls, which I know what those are. And this one was just set inside the cave. That's all of them. We just have two quests. So let's head all up here and let's go. There's a knuckle bandit. It's a knuckle sandwich. Can we jump up there? Nope. We're actually getting close to the point where it will give us the thing. Hopefully, will you give us the thing? You're not going to give us the thing, are you? Nope. No, I did. Okay, good. I am going to go back down there real quick and take care of the enemy, then we get this quick travel up here. And before quick travel is disabled. By the way, that does happen during like major events, or, well, yeah, major events. Sometimes there was disabled skip travel, so you have to walk all the way back to stuff. Which is not that bad. It's actually not that bad. It actually is kind of good because you fight enemies along the way and it's just like level up. Now the thing is, if you do every quest and fight enemies along the way, you will get over leveled. And when you get over leveled, yeah, it makes this game so easy. Anyway, if we drop down here, we go to Cliff Lake. Now you might notice there's gonna be some high level enemies. Like these beach gravels, man, looks so strong. But yeah, Speedy Ramsay. I never actually fought this guy before. He's level 10. We might be able to take him on. Should we take him on? You know, might as well try it. We're gonna focus on this guy. Have everything on us. If anything, he's not focusing Shulk. Oh yeah, that's Shulk's new art, which is Shadow Eye. What it does, it doesn't really disable aggro, but it lowers the aggro. Yeah, that we can definitely not fight these guys. Joel, can you please? No. So we can't fight those guys, but at least when we get high enough level, we can go back and fight these guys. I totally forgot those guys are even there. I don't even think I can fight them in Rainfall. Oh, I just noticed something.
You forgot something. You will be needing the transport cases, right?
Fiora.
Ah. I'm coming along as well. I'd feel better going with you boys than sitting at home worrying about you. So, let's get moving.
I knew she didn't trust me. Looks like it.
Yeah, that's what I remember, because if you died, this was the last thing and this is a cutscene. Oh well. Anyway, keep an eye on the party gauge. Level equipment. If you're not able to win a battle, check the level difference, blah blah blah, stuff like that. New thing. Chain attack. I'll go over the chain attack, which actually... But anyway, guess what? Quest. The most important thing. But yeah, now we have Fiora with us again. Which makes stuff super interesting. Which, actually, I think I got a knife for her. Yeah, it does increase your damage, but lowers your stuff. So no, we'll go with that. Go with bouncer knives. Is there any equipment for you? We do not. If I want to, I'd give her this. But to be quite honest, I kind of like her default costume, I guess you could say. Now the thing is, most of the time it's just colors, and I actually did not mean to do that. But yeah, most of the time it is just a recolor for things. And that is what Spreading Armor is. It's usually characters. If you take everything off, they usually have like a swimsuit or something like that. And that's what the swimming thing is, just being completely naked. For a good example is Smash for Shulk's fourth costume is his swimming wear. Now I'm like, what's the point of that, going no armor? Actually, there is kind of. There's some skills later in the game that if you have no equipment on, guess what? You get increased agility, is what and agility works like more. Your hits will do more. You will hit more, and their hits will miss, kind of thing. Something like that. Anyway, we're going to go. If we wanted to, we can take these guys on again. But we have to do something first, which is take care of these colony crabbles. So, what is the talent gauge? See that little thing up there? When you attack enemies, or when you do bonus effects, I should say. So what happens is we're just gonna, if the thing fully fills up. So yeah, leave it to Ryan. But now Fiora's with us, and it's super great. Now we have three people, and it's awesome. Shulk, where are you going? So that talent gauge, it slowly depletes over time. But when you have three, you can do a chain attack. Which I want to try my best to show that off. And if you die, using one whole of those things, well, guess what? Revive people. So we have the ability to revive. So now if people die, we can heal up. Because that guy's only level 5, so we're not that bad. We have a way to daze. Oh. So now it's going to tell us about chain attack, and I'll explain all the chain attacks myself. I think the last rate is, no, that's a different move. I think it's bleed. Bleed is like a damage over time debuff. It's like poison, but I think it's just based on enemy's maximum health percentage. I'm talking League talk, but it uses the exact same thing. We got a gold chest. Nice. Okay, let's just take that. By the way, it all, like I said, it depletes over time. So what we're going to do is play Shulk, Rein, and Fiora. And I probably said like, oh, what's the point of 1, 2, and 3? That's the order of the chain attack. Anyway, I never really went over Fiora's skills. We have Zeal, Courage, and Daring. Which one would be the best? Grant strength above start of battle, or increase block rate when HP is at half. I think courage would probably be the best. Yeah, let's stay at courage. So, now these bundles. We lost last time. We're probably going to lose again, but let's try our best at it again. And actually, if we wanted to, why can I not use the lore command? Screw it, we're just gonna fight this guy. Everyone, let's go. If we do backslash, I'm gonna go all out. So what I wanna do is we're gonna wait to get this filled up. And when it's filled up, I wanna make this wait a little bit. So what we're going to do is focus on this guy and chain attack. So what I can do is break, topple, and Fiora has a daze. So now we have him dazed and we can take care of this guy a lot more easier. But it's still going a little bit wrong because we have to deal with the. If we take care of this guy, we could run away. We're actually doing a little bit better than we did last time because Fiora's with us. Now we can revive him, but they get experience still, but we got to hold out. Now, something I did not explain about chain attack, which I probably should have, is colors. Now you might notice, it's a different, different colors. Like, hold on, let me just talk to this guy real quick. So we have a red one, a blue one, and would you say pink, I guess? If I was to use three reds in a row, it will do more damage because you're doing a chain of multiple colors. So you guys can see it gets to a point where it's pretty awesome like that. Chain attacks are awesome. They're like your main key when you fight bosses and stuff like that. Anyway, up to the top of here, we'll go ahead and do it real quick, and we have a heart-to-heart. So we're gonna view this real quick. There we go. It is for Wolf, Shulk, and Ryan. Every time we come here, I brings back memories. Same for you, right? Yep, we've been through a lot together, you and me. Oh yeah, you remember that time, you know, that one time? We don't let ourselves off. When we had a big fight. That's the one. It's easily the biggest bust up we ever had. In all these years, I know you, known you, nothing else has come close. It was bad, alright. It's just, I'm just glad we made up afterwards. You know what, such a big argument. I don't even remember what it was about. We were really young. It was probably just some silly kid thing. You're probably right. Hey, Shulk, do you ever think about it? Without me bringing it up, I mean. Of course. I think about it sometimes. If we never had that argument, I don't think we'd be friends now. That's just what I've been... Well, that's what I was thinking. We must have said some pretty harsh things to each other. But it was worth it, right? It's... Why are we such good mates now? Yeah, it's definitely worth it. You know, it's funny how we think alike sometimes. I figured you were still angry. Nah, not anymore. But you did get on my nerves a bit back then. You were just too clever, man. I don't... It got under my skin. And you thought... And I thought you were just this big dumb brute. Hey, I guess that's what we were arguing about. Yeah, that sounds about right. But after all that fighting, we came out stronger. And we learned about each other. You know, I don't say this enough. Thanks, Ryan. I couldn't ask for a better friend. No problem, Shulk. And remember, you don't have to hold back. You can call me a big dumb brute anytime you like. I'll take it on. Such great friendships, and of course, Fiora's just out there like, yeah, well, I don't know what's going on. Seeing as you're here, can you do one more thing for me? I want you to kill some male lizards. That's just generic quests. I don't have to actually read these. More quests? I know. So we can actually go inside now. Now, even though this is technically a story, we never really did anything. We just did two side quests. Actually, one of them was taking care of a unique monster. Tephra Cave. And Tephra Cave. You know, every time I see this picture, the picture of the Baroness, I always think of it like some huge dragon. Now, there are many types of monsters. There's visual types. Yeah, we leveled up, bro. And you learn a new art. Get to play as you now. We'll play as Fiora a little bit too. Just once you're off the new art, then we'll go play as Fiora. Yes. Anyway, and here we go. We got clap things. I don't think these are for quests, but we'll find them anyway. We have a new art. First we're gonna hammer beat, bone upper, rage. Well, that was for a quest, so I guess it was worth it. Anyway, the new art we got is engage. What it does is it makes sure the enemy locks onto you and they cannot focus anyone else. So if you want to use that, and we'll give you a lot of gold chests. What is going on, man? We should be okay if we fight like this. So that's good. That's the only quest chest we got. Okay. Now, the thing is, since we're in a new area, you guys might notice we have new stuff. And we still didn't get this one. We'll probably get that before we leave Colony 9, which we already did leave Colony 9. I don't know why we would leave anymore. Eater Caterpillar. Oh my god, we got Settle of Bagworm, which is actually an enemy we have to fight. So we're gonna fight him anyway. Everyone, focus this thing. What? Why? Oh, poison. Okay. Oh, okay, we got a jet. We're out. Skedaddle. We'll fight him later. Some other time. We'll walk past all these guys. And we have a singing frog, which I believe is for a quest. And Gosh, does he drop something we need?
Good luck, everyone.
I don't know why I should did that. War swing. I actually think it's Fiora has a topple. Nice attack, Fiora. Nice attack. Okay, I was gonna do this. We have air rings too. Okay, we're getting low on health. We have a chain attack. But I'm gonna save that for the guy back there. Gonna bone up for everything.
Should be okay if we fight like this.
Let's stay focused.
So we're gonna heal up and then we're gonna go try to take on that. We can't do it again, even with a chain attack. We'll just do it when we're a high level. So we're gonna play as Fiora for a little bit. Actually, did we have? I know we got some armor. So did we get anything new? Ryan got a better thing and it has aggro up. It's actually pretty useful. This gives us ether up, which isn't that good for us right now. Let's give this to Fiora. Anyway, let's give this more. So let's, oh my god, that looks actually pretty cool. But to be honest, I like having choke with light armor. It's just my personal thing. This also health, so I'm not gonna do that. Let's put that on Fiora. Now she doesn't have any gloves on, but it's not that big of a deal. We'll give that to Fiora, and we'll give this to Shulk. I like how in Xenoblade Chronicles X, you can set costumes to your characters, which is so much better so you can wear stuff and have your characters look the way you want it to.
Is everybody ready?
Okay, so attack. Oh my god, that does so much damage. Okay, well, so what we're gonna do is lacerate. And backslash, even though we're in the front. And hammer thing. Oh, we get a third attack. And we're going to power smash. That was great. Not really. We barely did a thing to him. Topple him. And I can daze him. Oh no, we have a inflict break. I thought we had a top one. Oh, do not focus. Well, actually, no, we're pretty much fine. Chain attack. Chain attack. We got this. A power smash. I'm on the side, so. Let's go down.
I know.
Yeah, bone upper.
This is how we do it.
We did it.
You're mine.
Oh, don't focus me. Come on, someone. No, we're so close. It focused me at the wrong time. So we technically can take on that guy. I'm not going to focus on him right now, so we're just going to skip past him. We'll come back later. Technically, I could do it now. You know what? A part of me wants to do it. We're doing it. Actually, we can go up there too if we wanted to, which I think I want to go up there. Okay, I'm going to go to behind, turn it around, and power smash. Okay, I'm gonna go behind and focus him. Now I'm gonna flick break. I really don't want it to focus me. Okay, we fall down now. I wanna try to keep the bleed on him as much as I can. Alright, I never actually mentioned this, but the talent gauge counts as basically a wild color. So if you use, like, blue, you can use the thing as well. Where is Ryan at? So you focus at... Okay, revive me, please. Revive me, please. Okay, we're gonna encourage him. Oh, we can't do it. We can't do it. I screwed up. The reason we got it last time is because... Oh, there's another one here. I didn't even heal up all the way, and I'm died.
I'm sorry.
Okay, so I'm playing the guy again. See if we have a chain of three. I can do this. And do a times four, three chain attack. And I kind of don't want you to focus me anymore to... But luckily, we got enough to revive me. Thank you, guys. There we go. We did it. I was gonna be like, no, not again. Anyway, get all that stuff. No new art. Okay, but we got another Infinity Coin, which is pretty good. We're going to fight this guy over here because I just now noticed him. Actually, we want to take you on because you want to focus us. I know we didn't really make any progress. We're just doing a lot of questing. Oh, I'm focusing the guy in the back. Everyone needs to be focusing this guy, which is actually a quest, which is a plus side to us. And yes, we didn't really make much story progress. But it technically is because we did make progress. See, I don't know if I want to do that thing or not. Because I did that in episode 1, and I'm not going to use it in episode 1. I'm probably still going to do it. And this will count as story, even though we did a little bit of both. I feel like I can make it a little bit longer episode, because I'll probably be cutting out about like 10 minutes. So if it's a 45 minute episode, well, oh well. Now, this guy shouldn't be as hard because we took care of one that's 10 times more harder. Okay, topple him real quick. And daze him. Yeah, this guy is a lot more easier. Like, he's already half health. This is easy. And now, with all that said and done, you are dead. Okay, now you are.
Good or am I good? That is so you, Ryan.
Some of these things they say is just hilarious. Anyway, let's continue on. I think there's an item we need for that guy to drop. Let's go to Tephra Cave. We actually don't even have it. Is all Colony 9? We have Challenge 4, which is Wall Slide something. Monster Quest 4, which is take kill 5 Metal Lizards, and that's all. It's not a drop or anything. Okay. What we have to do is go up here. Magmel Ruins.
Are these the Magmel Ruins?
Haven't you been here before?
Nope.
The Defense Force often uses it for training. But I come here to do research. It's not really a place that people go.
Not surprising. There are monsters around here that use Mechon parts as armor.
Was this built by the Mechon?
I don't think so. There's a path for people to get in. It might have been a vehicle of some kind.
Like the Defense Force hover transports.
A vehicle? But it's so big.
It's amazing technology. I wonder what kind of people made it.
I ain't got a clue.
Let's keep moving. The ether cylinders are up ahead.
Right.
Take shortcut by skip traveling. Nidus now telling us that. It's like, yeah, you guys never used this before. We level up with the... I almost spoiled someone's a future party member's name because it came to my head. But, oh, I think, yeah, you're not in the quest. I don't know why I'm battling you. But we leveled up with Fiora. Anytime I spoil anything, I'm probably just going to cut my commentary out just so it doesn't spoil anything. But, you know, I need to fuck up anyway. We all make mistakes. Anyway, I think if we come up here, it's a button. Can't do anything about it, so we can't do anything. Actually, no, I think we can do something about it, but we can't do it. We have to come up here. No, it's over here. We can't do nothing over there. But we can come over here, and as you see, there's a whole bunch of these male lizards. Actually, the best thing to do is not play as Fiora. No, it's fine. We'll play as her still. But as you see, if we come over here, this is where it's on camera, please. I think this is where we have to go. But what if we went this way? We have to fight well, so you don't visit whatever his name is. Wanna flex break real quick? Okay, let's daze him real quick. Let's do this. We're good. We get to fight another unique monster, which is pretty good. Get as much unique coins, I mean, infinity coins as you can. It's perfect. And almost. And dead. Okay. I say it void before he dies. We got a new skill learned with the Fiora. I never really mentioned this, but the tiny bar under the, like, under the portrait, then you have like those big squares. The squares are experience to level up your character. The small one is for your, what is it for? It's for your skills. So if you see those, when that's close to level up, it's not you about to level up, it's your skills. It means about to learn a skill. Wow. Fantastic. I just love how we kill these guys in one hit. Joke. He just keeps one-shotting everything. Oh, wasn't let's do this, guys. Let's fight this, guys. And that time we didn't one-shot it, which is fine because that means the other guy will spawn. And now we kill them all. Now my quest is done. We got some quests done. We got these quests done. We got the quests done. We got the quests done. And one more. We got the quests done. There we go. So, we technically don't have to fight these two, which we're not going to because it's not required. So, we're just going to skip past them and keep on going. And if you come up here, we got a cave rat. Perfect. Good. 10 out of 10. Thing is, I actually streamed this a couple months ago. Actually, I think it was... I don't know when I streamed this. I streamed it once, I know. I only streamed for like a good 10 minutes because it started to lag. Which is fine. I'm not gonna stream anymore. Anyway, where we have to go is, well, actually right there, but I don't want to trigger it because next time on Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles, we will go to, well, there. But before we end off, look at the scenery of Colony 9. We started this adventure down there, walked all the way, oh my god. Achievement! Hopefully there's a way back up there. Thank god. I didn't mean to do that. But anyway, we started right down there. We walked all the way over there. To Colony 9, if I can draw these. We didn't really make a long distance, but as you can see, this game is humongous. Like, look at this. Like, look at all this. And look at like, what's above us. Clouds. It's beautiful. Anyway, next time let's play Xenoblade Chronicles, we will go to the cylinder thing, which is right there. See you guys later.